People think only a video or a podcast mm-hmm. or a book mm-hmm. can tell a story, but one single visual can tell a story. That's a successful piece of art.
That's amazing. I was, while you were discussing, talking about how your process works, I was contemplating asking you, sharing your thoughts on the upcoming fight and what would you do for a poster. Do you think that sort of thing shouldn't be discussed at all because that's your sort of intellectual property and you don't want anyone to use that?
No, I mean, we could talk about it. I'd have to think it through, but let's try. Why not? I've never done that before.
Well, the fight that I was thinking about is the third one between Triple G and Canelo. And as you know, there's a lot of drama around it. There's a lot of things that are involved, and there's a lot of history over, like starting from all the way from 2014, 15, I would say, yeah. All these fights were marinating and discussed. And now with the third fight that is rumored, according to sources online, including ESPN, that the fight might happen on September 12th. And so I'm just wondering, like, what kind of emotions would you draw upon if you would make a poster for that fight?
At this point, I think the most the lowest hanging fruit that you should be attaching yourself to is the bad blood between these guys at this point. And so I would definitely have that at the forefront of my mind while thinking of how to do it. That doesn't mean that you have to do the classic face to face with the scowl necessarily, but mm-hmm. whether it's in the colors, going with an aggressive, powerful font, whatever it might be, I would definitely move away from the second poster. I was not a huge fan of it. I appreciated what they were trying to do with some of the colors, but I would move away from just a standard two guys punching each other type of thing. We all know that's what these guys do. So mm-hmm. we don't need to tell that part of the story mm-hmm. that they fought and that they will fight again. Let's go with a real storyline about revenge. Because to me now, Canelo this whole time over the last year or so has been trying to take food out of Triple G's mouth, in my opinion. And Triple G is jaded. You know him much better than I do, but jaded about the fact that he got screwed in his mind twice. So I think it has to be something around that. That's how I would approach that one.